The Large Hadron Collider is a 27-kilometer-long accelerator located at CERN, the European Laboratory for Particle Physics. The LHC smashes two beams of protons against each other in four different locations. The result of the collisions might reveal fundamental questions related to the origins of the matter and the origin of the universe itself. To produce a large enough amount of collisions, the size of the beam at the interaction point is of the order of micrometers. But there are some particles that remain in the outer regions of the beam. This is what we call beam halo. The LHC integrates a collimation system that removes the halo particles and protects the machine, at the same time cleans the beam to get more precise collisions. The beam halo may create two very important issues. First, the beam halo generates large quantities of background noise in the detector, reducing the precision of the experiment. Secondly, if some particles of the beam hit the cold regions of the accelerator, the superconductivity state of the magnet might get lost, creating a major issue on the accelerator performance. In 2015, the LHC will start running again at energies never achieved before. The collimation system layout must be revisited and redesigned in order to accommodate the major changes the LHC and its upgraded version HL-LHC are going to face in the next years. The optimization of the new system is performed using robust and complex computational tools. Among these computational tools, SigTrack is a robust and widely used tracking software to formally compute the dynamic aperture that now includes an extension that takes into account the beam pipe apertures and the collimation gaps. BDSim is a new tool developed at Royal Holloway that allows a computation of the losses in the magnet aperture, much like SigTrack, but also takes into account the influence of the generation of secondaries and their energy deposition in the magnet. With these tools, we are able to track the exact trajectories of the particles of the beam halo to study their behavior and the efficiency of the collimation system. It is therefore fundamental to optimize the LHC collimation system according to the new requirements that will impose the future colliders.
As a layman, I would now say, I think we have it.
The LHC collimation system has demonstrated a very good performance, and the final success of the LHC experimental program relies on it.